Hi everyone. Today in this video, we are going to discuss about rosuvastatin. The drug rosuvastatin is a HMG Co-A reductase inhibitor. This drug is classified as statins because this drug is having the suffix vastatin. Rosuvastatin is well known with its brand name Crestor, and this drug is particularly affecting the lipid levels such as LDL as well as HDL. The LDL cholesterol, which is also called as bad cholesterol, this LDL cholesterol is responsible for development of atherosclerosis, the narrowing of blood vessels by formation of atheroma within the intima of the blood vessels. Now, in this atheroma, LDL cholesterol is involved. So, the patients with raised LDL cholesterol levels, there will be increased risk of atherosclerosis, which reduces the blood flow, resulting in the risk of stroke, myocardial infarction and other cardiovascular complications. But at the same time, HDL cholesterol can prevent the atherosclerosis. That's why it is called as good cholesterol. So within the limits, HDL cholesterol can reduce the deposition of cholesterol within the atheroma such that the atherogenesis can be reduced. Now, rosuvastatin is one of the drugs which can reduce the risk of atherosclerosis and other cardiovascular complications by reducing the LDL levels and increase the HDL levels. That's why this rosuvastatin can be used in different types of dyslipidemia. Among them, rosuvastatin can be used in the treatment of type 3 hyperlipoproteinemia. So this is one type of dyslipidemia where the lipoprotein levels are elevated, but here LDL is not involved. In this type 3, we can observe elevated levels of beta VLDL. The beta form of VLDL, another lipoprotein which is carrying the triglycerides. So, this lipoprotein levels are elevated, which results in the type 3 hyperlipoproteinemia. In such conditions, rosuvastatin can reduce the VLDL levels. So, this drug is not only acting on the LDL and HDL, it can also reduce the VLDL levels. Similarly, this drug can also be used in familial hypercholesterolemia. This hypercholesterolemia can be classified into two types. Type 2A, where there is increased levels of LDL levels, and type 2B, where there is increased levels of both LDL as well as VLDL can be observed. So, in both of these conditions, rosuvastatin can be used. In this way, rosuvastatin can be used in the hypercholesterolemia as well as mixed dyslipidemia, where both LDL as well as VLDL levels are increased. In such conditions, this drug can reduce the lipoprotein levels, thereby can reduce the risk of atherosclerosis and related cardiovascular complications such as stroke, myocardial infarction. All this can be reduced by use of this rosuvastatin. Now, let us see the chemical nature of this drug. So, this is the structure of rosuvastatin. And here we can observe a long chain with carboxylic acid. So, let us give the numbering. This is 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7. So it is 3,5-dihydroxy, and chain is composed of 7 carbons with double bond at 6th position, which can be represented as hept-6-enoic acid. So 3,5-dihydroxy-hept-6-enoic acid is present in the rosuvastatin, which is mainly responsible for inhibition of HMG CoA reductase activity. Now this chain is attached to another heterocyclic ring system, which is nothing but pyrimidine 5-aryl. In this way, rosuvastatin is a free acid, which is an active drug, and it does not require any metabolism for activation. So, it can directly inhibit the HMG-CoA reductase enzyme, thereby it can inhibit the synthesis of cholesterol within the liver. Now, let us see the precautions. One of the important precautions of rosuvastatin is on the skeletal muscle. So, this drug can affect the skeletal muscle, resulting in the myopathy, the damage to the muscle. So, it can produce some muscle weakness in the patients as well as muscle pain, malaise, feeling of discomfort, weakness, fever can also be observed. And particularly, this myopathy can be increased with increased dose as well as duration of the treatment. Myopathy produced by rosuvastatin is not because of the parent drug. This drug exists as free acid form, but in vivo, it can be converted into another form, the lactone form. When this side chain is going to be closed into a ring, it can form a lactone. This lactone can act on the respiratory chain. So, particularly complex 3 is going to be targeted by this lactone. Now, the lactone form of this rosuvastatin can act on the complex 3, thereby can inhibit this respiratory chain, so that from the mitochondria, the release of ATP molecules is going to be reduced. At the same time, free radicals are more produced, resulting in the muscle damage and myopathy. And with increase in the dose, rosuvastatin can also produce rhabdomyolysis, the damage and dissolution of muscle fibers. So the creatine kinase levels are going to be increased up to 10 times with increased dose of rosuvastatin. Other coexistive factors can also increase the risk of rhabdomyolysis in the patients. If any patient is having a severe dehydration or any renal failure, recent major surgery, trauma, or severe hypotension, sepsis, all these conditions can further increase the rhabdomyolysis produced by rosuvastatin. Similarly, if you have the factors such as age, in the elders with age greater than 65, similarly the female patients are having more risk than male patients, and uncontrolled hypothyroidism, all these factors can also increase the risk of rhabdomyolysis. So when this drug is going to be prescribed in the elders as well as female patients or the patients with uncontrolled hypothyroidism, care should be taken to monitor any damage to the skeletal muscle. Similarly, rosuvastatin can also affect the liver and it can increase the liver enzymes. The alanine transaminase levels are going to be increased as well as aspartate transaminase levels are also increased. That's why when this drug is going to be prescribed for longer periods, liver functionality test should be done in order to assess any hepatic damage. Particularly, elevation of liver enzymes can be observed after 3 months of treatment. So, liver functionality test should be done after 3 months of the treatment so that we can assess any hepatic injury. In case of any elevation of liver enzymes such as AST levels up to 3 times of their upper normal limit, then immediately the dose of rosuvastatin should be reduced in order to prevent further liver damage in the patients. Similarly, rosuvastatin can also increase the precipitation of proteins resulting in the proteinuria as well as hematuria. Similarly, it can also increase the action of warfarin resulting in the increased risk of hemorrhage. It can also affect the endocrine hormones resulting in the increased HbA1c levels, which indicates elevated levels of glucose, and if it is untreated, it may lead to some diabetes in the patients. Now let us see how this drug acts. Rosuvastatin mainly acts on the mevalonate pathway. So within the hepatocytes, cholesterol is biosynthesized through this mevalonate pathway. But for the mevalonate, the important precursor is the HMG CoA. This HMG CoA is going to be reduced by another enzyme, HMG CoA reductase enzyme. So now by the action of this enzyme, the HMG CoA molecules can be converted into mevalonate. In this way, HMG CoA can be converted into mevalonate by HMG CoA reductase enzyme. Once this mevalonate is synthesized, it can be converted into cholesterol by several number of steps. So within the hepatocytes, cholesterol is biosynthesized. But when this rosuvastatin is administered, this hepatic cholesterol synthesis can be inhibited. Now, rosuvastatin can block this HMG CoA reductase enzyme such that it can inhibit the cholesterol biosynthesis within the liver. Since HMG CoA reductase enzyme is responsible for the rate determining step within the cholesterol biosynthesis, the entire turnover of cholesterol biosynthesis can be controlled by rosuvastatin. Now, when this liver is not synthesizing the cholesterol, it can get the cholesterol from the LDL. For that, it can increase the expression of LDL receptors on the hepatocytes. Now, the LDL cholesterol which is present in the blood can be taken by the liver through these LDL receptors. Within the hepatocytes, lysosome play an important role in the digestion and release of free cholesterol. In this way, cholesterol is again produced within the liver by uptake of LDL cholesterol. But because of this action, the levels of LDL cholesterol within the blood is going to be reduced, which reduces the risk of atherosclerosis. In this way, rosuvastatin can reduce the LDL cholesterols as well as it can also reduce the VLDL levels, and it can also raise the HDL levels, thereby it can reduce the risk of stroke and myocardial infarction. What are the side effects? The important side effects of rosuvastatin are mainly myalgia, muscle pain, abdominal pain, nausea, headache, asthenia, lack of energy, constipation, dizziness, arthralgia, joint pain, and some jaundice. Hepatitis can be observed with increased dose of rosuvastatin. How it is given? This drug is given as a tablet, normal tablet, as well as film coated tablet, and it is available at different strengths such as 5 mg, 10 mg, 20 mg, as well as 40 mg. So 40 mg is the high dose of this drug, which should be used only in few of the patients with high levels of LDL cholesterol. So initial dose of the drug is variable from 10 to 20 mg given as once daily, and the dose can be increased up to 40 mg based on the goal and control of LDL levels. But at 40 mg dose, there may be a chance of development of myopathy and liver dysfunction. So it is better to use in the low dose in order to avoid muscle and liver dysfunction. So that's about this drug, rosuvastatin. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your friends. Post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.